Well, hello my people, welcome back to my channel. What is up? And yes, I am back. Finally, I'm back. I know it's been a while since I last uploaded a video. I'm very sorry, but I've been having some little difficulties that I've already overcome. Antes de comenzar, si ustedes hablan en español, por favor hagan clic en la cajita que está por aquí abajo con las dos C para que les salgan los subtítulos en español. In regards to my last video, I'm gonna talk about it in a completely separate video, and I will tell you the reason why I stopped making videos for so long. Anyway guys, the amazing director, filmmaker Susan decided to make a mini documentary on me and my trips overseas. It's a pretty cool mini documentary, so please guys, check it out. And I have to let you know that I'm going to Poland, so by the time you're watching this video, I will be in Poland. Stick around because there will be many videos, including Auschwitz, coming up in this channel. So stay tuned and don't miss out the fun. Check out my Instagram account because I am very active there. Go see all my daily stories, my daily pictures. And that's it guys, without further ado, let's watch this documentary. I hope you enjoy it. Make sure you follow the amazing director Susan and her crew. I'll be leaving the links to their social media here in the description below. And make sure you follow them and check out their amazing content. That's it guys, let's go. My passion of traveling started at a very young age, when I was around 16, that I made the decision to go overseas, because my mom always went overseas when I was a kid, and I always looked at the pictures and it just looked amazing. And when I came to Australia, just experiencing being by myself outside of my country and experiencing other cultures, I went first to Buenos Aires. That was a layover coming to Australia. That experience overseas kind of lit a little flame inside of myself. Travel really opens you up to the wonders of the world. I can relate that to my current job. I'm a registered nurse. For me, traveling, it's very similar to nursing. It sounds weird, but it's very similar to nursing because you connect with people. You are actually living with them, living their culture, because once a patient is hospitalized, they become like part of your life and you become like part of their life. Basically, all the experiences overseas have been life-changing. Every single country that I've visited, I've learned something, and like I've learned new things, I've had different experiences. All of them have impacted my life in different ways. But I would say in Japan and Beijing, because it's so different to my own culture, it's so different to Colombian or Australian culture. I'm Catholic. The main religion in Japan is Shintoism and Buddhism, which are so different to Catholicism. When you experience travel, you meet a lot of people, and people are the ones that make the experience. Because you meet so many people when you travel, all of them, of course, they have different personalities. Like back home, that we meet people that are shy, people that are very enthusiastic. It happens the same overseas. But there is a little twist. I mean, it's a little bit different because they were raised in a different environment, a different culture, so the perspectives are different. For example, it was very unusual for me to see how the Shintoism practitioners believed that the smoke that they put in front of the shrine would purify them, would heal them, would give them better health. Like in my mind, I was like, how can they believe that? But once they told me that ever since they were kids, they were told these stories and everything, and throughout life, they actually experienced it in their culture. They believe that it works, and for them, it has worked. So I was like, wow. So they actually believe that it works. So it's the same way as me in my own home country, when I use, for example, when I take Panadol for pain, that I believe it works, it ends up working. So the same thing is for them in smoke. Like, they believe it works and it works for them. So we're actually very similar. So you learn from every person you meet. I believe that travel is always about the journey and not the destination. That's a really good thing that we can learn from this whole experience and from all the experiences that you guys have in life when it comes to travel. It's all about the people you meet, it's all about the people you connect with, about the journey and not really the destination.